So, good morning. As you probably know by the beginning of the video, we're in Elkmont. And it's a little bit windy, maybe. Might get a little bit windy, so you may hear some wind noise. But today, I'm going to show everybody how to get to Avent Cabin. Now, I know everybody's seen pictures and some video from up there, but getting to it, it's kind of tricky. It's not marked. I'm going to show you how to get there. But please, 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 if you go up there, don't mark on the walls. It's the one place in the Smokies that is still pristine. And, you know, it'd be kind of nice to leave it that way. It's a little known cabin. History and everything is going to be down there in the description. But the starting point is the road that we just came in on. Come to Elkmont. Go toward, you know, take a left there, Jake's Creek Trailhead. Come up here and park. You can see I'm parked in the upper parking. And from here, we walk. So, come on along, and let's take a walk up to Avent Cabin. This road here, this is going to Jake's Creek Trail. So you're gonna walk up by all these houses. This is considered Society Hill. And you're probably gonna hear heavy breathing by me. But here we go, folks. I'll check in when we get to the Y. Okay. At this point, we've pretty much reached the end of what's left of Daisy Town. There's one more house that's up on the left. Let me tell you, that's a walk, but still got quite a bit to go. On up this way, there's another house that's off to the left, and then one at the Y, and then the next stop we'll be at is the stables. But like I said, I'll check in at the Y, so you kind of know which direction to walk. Okay, this is the Y. This is where you gotta make a choice. Okay, this trail, going off to your left, is the route that most people take. That's the Jake's Creek Trail. And yes, that will take you to Avent Cabin. I'm going to show you a way that cuts off maybe about an eighth of a mile. That's this way. This is an old road that goes up to the stables. It's the old stables that used to be up here in Elkmont. Sorry, having a hard time breathing. And this is a little bit better route. If you go Jake's Creek is fine. It's a good wide trail, road, about like this. But it goes way up out of the way. And it's a lot of uphill. This has uphill, but not quite as much. And on this route, you got views like that. So, let's walk up to the stables, and then we'll go from there. Okay, we are at Hill Stables, which they do still use up here. So now you've reached the stables. Hold on. You've walked all the way up that hill. Starting to get a little warmer. Now the sun's coming over the ridge. Okay, so now you're up here. The way you want to go is walk up to the end of the loop. There's the trail. This one goes and cuts over Jake's Creek to Jake's Creek Trail, which is about halfway up there on the side of the hill there. So we're going to walk this way. The sun's coming through. That's starting to feel good. You come to the mountains, dress for any occasion. I got all kinds of layers going on, so I can lose them as I go, or put them back on if I'm up here too late, which I shouldn't be. If I even make it. So, I'll catch you at the bridge. Isn't it pretty up here? Look at those trees. Just beautiful in the sunlight. Winter time's a whole different hike up through here. You can see a lot more through the trees. Yeah, it's a little cold, but it's East Tennessee. You get days like this, you just got to get out and do it. Okay. I'll catch you in just a minute. Oh yeah. One more thing about this trail. When you walk this one, wear your waterproof shoes. Because there's quite a few spots like this. You will get your feet wet. Okay. Now you're gonna see a sign that says Meigs Mountain Trail. Meigs Mountain Trail goes that way or that way. You want to go that way. So when you come to this sign, go left. And this is going to take you down. Watch the roots. To Jake's Creek. Okay, at this point, really nice spot right down there. If it's summertime, that's a good soaking spot. It's a little beach, but we don't want to go that way. We want to go left. And let me switch hands. So I don't want to lose the camera going across, because it is a little bit slick. But you want to walk across Jake's Creek. And right about here, you want to stop. And you want to get a view of that. Okay, so now that we've crossed Jake's Creek, see where it Y's here? Don't go that way. Okay, up through there actually used to be a cabin up in there. But it's no longer there. There's a foundation for it. Had a really good spot. The way you want to go is up the big hill. So, here we go. I just had to look at the camera because I was looking at the screen. Could have swore I wasn't recording. And I sure wasn't going to go back and do that again. Okay. So this trail here goes up. And if you see up here, that's Jake's Creek trail up there. Which is the trail that goes off to the left at the beginning of all of this. That goes way uphill and circles around. So let's get up to the top and I'll check back in. Okay, I'm back. We're almost to the top. You see down there, that's where we were. That's the hill. Okay. See the sign up here? Let's walk up. Okay. That's where we are. Another fork in the road. But we are now on Jake's Creek Trail. So we want to go this way. You may be saying to yourself, boy, it looks like a road. Well, it was. This was railroad first when the logging was up here. And then when the logging left and the park took over, it was a road for a good while. But we still got a ways to go. I'll check back with you in just a little bit. I know, you thought I was there. Nope, we're still walking. We gotta go that way. I guess I should have mentioned the last sign that we passed. It's roughly a third of a mile from there up to the cutoff for Avent Cabin, which is unmarked and it's off to the right. So when we get up to it, I'll show you what you got to look for, because you can walk right by it and not even know you were at the trail if it's summertime. So I'll check in with you here in just a minute. Yeah, I'm gonna sit here for a little bit. Nope, not there yet. Just another sitting spot. Figured I'd sit here and do a quick breathing treatment. Give you a view. Just so you know, haven't passed one single person. And nobody's passed me. It's Sunday afternoon, January 31st, 2016. And not a soul out here. There were a few cars down in the parking lot, but the ones at the bottom parking lot are out on Millionaire's Row checking it out. And the ones up at the top are up here on the backcountry campgrounds There's backcountry camping. I call it a campground. It's not a campground. They've got shelters and camping areas up here in the backwoods. So I'd say that's where they were. But, yeah. So let me do a breathing treatment. Get opened back up a little bit. And then we'll be on our way. Okay, just wanted to give you a glimpse. If you can see it, you won't see it during the summer. See that right there? That is Avent Cabin. So we are almost there. We just got a little ways up here to the trail that goes across to over there. So I'll check back when we get to that. Okay, I'm back. Here we are walking. Avent's over there somewhere. Let's walk up the trail. This is what you're looking for. You're going to be walking along. It is not marked. If you're walking in the middle of the trail, you're going to miss it. Here's what you're looking for. It's a trail. Keep looking off to your right. After you've walked about a third of a mile, quarter to a third, you look down to your right and you see the steps. Now, from here, carefully, because this washes out right here. You're gonna walk down this little You're gonna walk down this little skinny trail. And I may turn the camera off while I'm walking down through here. But I'm gonna try and keep it on. So you know about where to go. Summertime. Up through here, you'll notice it's pretty thick up through here, and they do get up here every once in a while and take a machete to it, and some hikers do too. This place is taken care of by the hikers that actually find it. You'll see when we get up to the cabin, there's tools broom, shovel, rake. They're left there for everybody to do their part. Keep it clean. Oh good, it's still there. Okay, what we're coming up on, here's a little trivia for you about the Great Smoky Mountains. You see off in the distance there, this is actually listed as the longest footbridge in the Smokies. I'm not too sure about that, but it's a long one. Okay, this is where I was telling you, you're gonna get your feet wet. The trail is actually the creek. So let me turn this off and I'll catch you at the bridge. Okay, I'm back. That doesn't look like much, but it's slick. So here we are. Footbridge. I'm about to switch hands because I use every bit of that rail. And I'm sure nobody's been on this for a little bit. So we'll give it a good stomp. Nope, seems good. Beautiful up here. Okay, here we go. You'll notice it gets narrower. No, seriously, it's just as much fun as it looks like. No problem. So now, see this creek bed here? See this running water coming? Guess what? That's the trail. So yeah. Waterproof hiking boots or shoes. A really good thing to have. And it's steep. Hold on just a second. See it? It's up there. Okay, let me navigate this. Get right back to you. Ta-da! Meet you up there. Okay, here we are. Now this door, you gotta go in the back door. And normally that rock is up against the door. Somebody forgot to put the rock against the door to hold the door shut. I'm hoping y'all can see in here. Hoping there's enough light. As you can see, I leave some tools up here, rakes, and yeah, some people do camp up here every once in a while, which they blocked off the fireplace. Little bit of this, little bit of that. I don't know if I want to look underneath that bucket. Okay, kind of glad I didn't. But there's always some Windex up here, so you can clean the windows if you feel so inclined. And let's see if it'll pick up here. That's the upstairs, and yeah, it's got a little balcony rail. But this is it. And if you notice, one thing that differs here compared to other buildings in the park, see, not many people find this up here. Not many people go out of their way. It's not something that's easy to access. Just hop out of your car and go look at. So no graffiti. And Mayna's son put these windows in so Mayna could look out here. Used to be apple trees out there. But she would sit here and paint. And that brought in the light. You can see there's all kinds of nails for hanging. Let's go out on the porch. This door, I brought up some paper towels because there never seems to be, that's the one thing you never find up here. I think everybody's wiping with them or something. But I brought some paper towels. So let's go out here on the porch. There's your view. Somebody found a shovel. That's what I came up with today. I packed the house. Now, Mayna's cabin used to have another kitchen, but then this one was built because the bears, hold on while I move the rock. The bears got into it. The last one. Oh, let's open that door for a little bit. Okay. And here's the only writing on the walls you'll find here. It says, mice, important, snakes. Please leave door closed, especially at night. Keep door closed at all times, skunks. So, now, when you get up here, Nashville cook stove. This was her separate kitchen. And apparently there's some new stuff underneath here. You'll come up and you'll find, tools and tape. Okay, you'll come up here and you'll find all kinds of different things. But see all the pens in the cup here on the wall. This is a complete history when it was put on the National Register of Historic Places, the registration form near Elkmont. Period of significance was 1919 to 1940 art, and 1850 was considered an exploration settlement. So you can flip through here, you can find plans, you know, the drawings, where it's located, all of the paperwork that has to do with this cabin. And then when you get so far into it, there's photos in here of when Mayna used to live here. So you can see what it looked like then. And there's more photos. One-handed doesn't work very well. So it really is just a little hidden gem out here. Here's some of her paintings. So when you get up here, flip through all of that. Some really good stuff. And then make sure you sign the logbook. Please sign the logbook. You'll find a pen. See, the last person up here was yesterday. There was a few people up here from Kodak, Gatlinburg, Asheville, Alcoa. So yeah, there was quite a few people up here. Make sure you sign the logbook and then enjoy the place. It really is special. It's a hidden treasure, and I debated on giving up so much information on it, but just, you know, heed the history. Don't screw it up. It's a beautiful place to come up here and just relax. It's gonna take you a couple hours. It took me 4, so you know, it's gonna take a while. But okay, I'm gonna sign the book and then I'll get back to you in here in just a second. Thank you. really hope you enjoyed it. This is Avent Cabin. Come up, enjoy it. Sit out here on the porch. Enjoy the views. Have a snack. It's a good place to relax. Good place to just be. And just enjoy the mountains. It was worth it. I'll pay for it over the next few days, but it was worth it to come up one more time. That's it. All that's left is sitting here, having a snack, having some root beer, and heading back down the hill. Guess it's all downhill from here. Hope you enjoyed. Thanks for joining me on this